We are entering inside the Chittorgarh fort from the back side because vehicles can enter only from this side. The fort flaunts seven poles, that means seven gates, namely Hanuman, Jorla, Bhairo, Lakshman, Padan, Ganesh, and the main entrance is Ram Gate. Each of these gates is giant stone structures that are strongly fortified to withstand attack. Now we are crossing the Bhairo pole. The fort sits on a 180 meters high hill rising from the plains of River Beraj. Chittorgarh was the capital of Mewar Kingdom. Mira Temple or the Mirabai Temple, Rana Kumbh built it in an ornate Indo-Aryan architectural style. It is associated with the mystic saint poet Mirabai, who was an ardent devotee of Lord Krishna and dedicated her entire life to his worship. She composed and sang lyrical bhajans called Mira Bhajans. Here you can see the Vijay Stambh is an imposing victory in the fort. The tower was constructed by the Mewar king Rana Kumbh in 1448 to commemorate his victory over the combined armies of Malwa and Gujarat led by Mahmud Khilji. Jauhar is the act of mass self-immolation by women in India to avoid dishonor by Muslim invaders when facing certain defeat during a war. In Chittorgarh, a widow forced to sit atop her deceased husband's funeral pyre. But in Jauhar, women jump into fire to avoid disrespect of her sacrificing their lives. Chittorgarh has seen three Jauhars. The biggest Jauhar happened in 1303 when Rana Ratan Singh of Chittaur defeated against Allauddin Khilji of Delhi Sultanate and Rani Padmini, wife of Rana Ratan Singh, commit Jauhar with 13,000 women of Chittaur. Even child girl, pregnant women and old women were also amongst them. This is the place where Jauhar happened in 1303. Government now has filled the place with soil, but you can see the black spots in the stone wall, which are still prominent after several chemical washes by the government. Now we are near Gomukh Reservoir. About 40% of the fort is covered with water bodies in the form of ponds, wells or coons and step wells or bowries. Nearly 84 water bodies were built within the 700 hectares of fort area. At present, only 22 water bodies sustained. Gomukh Reservoir is one of the 84 water bodies. The nomenclature refers to the cow-shaped mouth which serves water to the reservoir. The Samadhishvara Temple is a Hindu temple located inside the fort. It is dedicated to Shiva, who is called Samadhishvara, that is Lord of Samadhi. Epigraphic evidence suggests that the temple was constructed in the 11th century and was further restored in the 13th and 15th centuries. Once upon a time, this was the residence of commander of Chittorgarh fort, but now it's almost ruined. Padmini Palace is the palace where Rani Padmini lived after she married Rawal Ratan Singh, the ruler of Mewar Kingdom. The majestic palace is a historical monument related to the self-sacrifice of Rani Padmini after Chittorgarh was attacked by the Sultan of Delhi, Allauddin Khilji. The two-story monument stands rather strong right at the center of the Chittorgarh fort, elevated on rocky terrain. The fort is surrounded by a lotus pool, which adds to the charm of the monument. This is the original border of the fort. From here you can see the Aravalli range. Rajasthan, Gujarat and Maharashtra are separated by Aravalli range. The highest point of Aravalli is Mount Abu. Girti Stambh is a 12th century tower situated at Chittaur Fort. The 22-meter high tower was built by a Jain merchant, Jija Bhagarwala, during the reign of Rawal Kumar Singh for the glory of Jainism. Now we are entering into the Rana Ratan Palace. That was the winter palace of the former Marwar royal family that was built on the orders of Ratan Singh II, who reigned from 1527 to 1531. The guide of the Chittorgarh fort is telling us that these are the tunnels whose exits are in different directions to jungle or to Gomukh reservoir or somewhere else. All these tunnels are now closed by the government.